work with them because not only because I could tell, okay, these are actors with a storytelling mind. These are actors who are going to exponentially lift my project. And not only that, also, okay, Olivia Colman, Jesse, Peter, Paul, Dakota, I see who they are. I mean, I didn't know you that well, Paul, but like, I know what I like. I didn't even see normal people. It was before normal people, and he made a tape for me, and I was like, done. And I could see, because it's what I do, like, okay, for Dakota to play Nina, for Paul to play Will, for Peter to play Professor Hardy, for Olivia to play Elena, Jesse, everyone. It's not just that I haven't seen them do it before. I haven't. But it's that I can tell that they have to, like, grow a little in order to do it, like, really well. And that's what I look for in a part for myself as an actress. So that's what I was casting for. And then, if you cast like that, and you respect and are curious about the people who are in your film, it's easy to love them. And to watch them, like, I mean, come on, this is an amazing gift to watch them. Then you're watching people, if you love them and they feel safe, you're watching people not pretend like they're learning what they need to learn in order to play this character well. You're watching them actually learn what they need to learn in order to play the character well, which is, to me anyway, like, endlessly fascinating and compelling.
I have a question for the actors, and I'd seen this film once with an audience, and this is the second audience, so forgive me for asking this, because I've never really known, and I hate this, like, the film critic, like, line of this, if this is going to be a gender split of a movie in terms of the reception, like, does it affect men different than it does for women, because this is obviously through the eyes of a woman, and we see women portrayed so honestly and raw in a way that conventionally American audiences are not used to, or cinematic audiences. Did you feel any of that, or did you have that same type of hesitation when you took on the role? Did you think this was made for one gender versus another? Did you feel that at all?
No, I didn't. I think I feel like this woman can tell this truth in this way. And I've also witnessed a few men recognize these women more than they recognize the usual female archetypes you see on film. You know, like, oh, that's my mother, or that's my aunt, my sister, my wife. But no, I didn't feel like it was I don't feel like it's just for women, this film. I think it's for everyone, but I do think it's a conversation that having a conversation, making a film about women having a conversation. And it's so important. I don't know that a man could have told this story this way, but a man could have told this story.
Peter or Paul, did you want to add anything to that? I feel like I need a fire extinguisher because you're on fire these days with Normal People in the last. Got yourself an Emmy nomination out of that, and then now you're working with this cast, and you're this eye to a lot of what we see happen. We learn more about Nina because of you. We learn more about Leda because of you. Can you speak about your involvement and how you saw yourself playing this story?
Yeah, I think it was about trying not to overcomplicate, but play it as truthfully as possible. And I was in the best hands with Maggie to guide that and not try to make things out of stuff that isn't there. And I think sometimes that's a hard thing to do because you want to make yourself busy, especially it was my first film, so you're looking at, okay, first day on sets with Dakota, the next day is with Olivia. It's kind of like sink or swim, or it feels like that. But I think approaching it was just, as you said, it's try to observe everything change from take to take, which Maggie totally allows. And for me in general, the project was just such a dream, because you're working with people at the top of their game. And it's thrilling and it's terrifying. And I think when those two things clash together, it results in something that I'm incredibly proud of. So, yeah.
We're filming until the end of September. I read like many, many books, but one of the things I read was Anna Karenina while listening to Maggie narrate it.
Wow.
Because she does the book on tape, which I really, really recommend, especially for the boring passages. It was like, I remember showing up to do the lecture, which for me felt like a huge, huge thing to try to, I mean, I can't emphasize this enough, I'm like really not an intellectual. I might come across that way for some reason, maybe it's got something to do with my voice.
Or your beard.
It's my beard.
Corduroys.
It's the corduroys. Clark's clothes.
Really trying hard. Still trying.
What does the audience think? I feel like we should all start polling. Like, what makes Peter look like a genius? No, please.
No, I mean, I've been... I usually don't care. I usually just go, whatever. They'll make me seem like a smart enough person to be the guy who can operate the nuclear power plants on board the submarine. But it's not me. You get tired of challenging yourself. At least I do. You know, and it's very easy. You know, you wonder why so many actors that give a good performance here and there don't always give a great performance, because it's very difficult. It's like being an athlete in some ways, maintaining a certain level of focus. And I've certainly gone in and out over the years of the amount that I can focus and the amount that I care, and it's, you know, it waxes and wanes. But there's no bullshitting your wife.